In lesson one, we talked about the cycle of day and night on Earth. And we said that a cycle is just a repeating series of events, like the life cycle of a butterfly or the cycle of a flower growing. And we said that with the cycle of day and night, the series of events is just the fact that for about half of a day it's daylight on Earth and about half of a day it's night. And we looked at this cycle and said that it takes about 24 hours to occur, and we talked about why it occurs. But we're going to make a model to demonstrate what's actually going on to cause this cycle of day and night on Earth. And for this model, we're just going to need a couple things. We need a styrofoam ball, and I'm going to use a dowel rod that I sharpened the end of. You could use a pencil or anything if you wanted to try this at home. And we're just going to take the dowel rod and stick it right into the center of our styrofoam ball so that I can hold it more easily. Now, the second material that we're going to need for this activity is just any lamp or fairly bright source of light. I've got a light bulb and a holder here that I can plug in, and this is going to be my light source. And essentially what we have here is a model of the sun and Earth. The light bulb is going to represent the sun, and the styrofoam ball is going to represent the Earth. And we're going to cut the lights out in just a minute, and we're going to look at why the cycle of day and night happens the way that it does. Now, with all the other lights in the room cut out, I've got my light bulb here. This is my one source of light. I'm going to set it off to the side, and it's going to represent the sun. And then I have the styrofoam ball again. This is going to represent Earth. And I've also got this piece of dowel rod here that's stuck through the ball. And this is going to represent something very important. It's going to represent the axis of the Earth. And we said that the axis is just that imaginary line straight through the center of the Earth that it's able to spin or rotate on. So as I turn the dowel rod, you can see that the Earth, the styrofoam ball, is rotating. And just to make it a little bit easier, so that we can kind of keep track of position, I'm just going to take my marker here, and I'm just going to put an X on the styrofoam ball. And this X is going to represent our location on Earth. All right? So again, you can see as the ball rotates, that position changes and moves, right? The Earth is staying essentially in the same place. It's just spinning. It's rotating on its axis. So we're going to look at how that actually affects and how that causes this cycle of day and night. So again, the light's representing the sun, the ball is representing the Earth, the dowel rod is representing the Earth's axis. And we're going to start out, right now our X is facing the sun. And you can see that no matter how I hold this, no matter how I rotate it, about half of the ball is always lit up by the light bulb. And about half the ball is always shadowed because the light from the sun, or the light bulb as the case may be, isn't hitting it. So this shows us already what's happening to cause day and night. We said that half of Earth is always experiencing day, and the other half is always experiencing night, and it's because of the fact that the sun can only light up half of Earth's surface at once. The other side is facing away from the sun, and it's shadowed. So if we take our X right here and we rotate the ball, we can see that as the Earth rotates, now we're moving into night. And that's the reason also on Earth, it doesn't just instantly go from really bright daylight to night, right? It starts getting a little darker. It starts getting a little darker because it's moving away, it's getting less of that sunlight until we get around to the other side where we're not getting any sunlight at all. And now it's going to be completely dark except for light from the stars, street lights, reflected light from the moon, and things like that. But again, you can see that even though it's dark on our side of the Earth, the other side of the Earth still has daylight. Half of the Earth is still lit up by the sun. We're just no longer in that half that is. But as we continue to rotate around very slowly, of course, I'm rotating much faster than the Earth actually rotates because the Earth takes 24 hours to rotate all the way around. But as we rotate back around, and if you could see the other side of the ball, the X is starting to move into the lit portion of the ball. So now the sunlight is reaching our location on Earth. We're having daylight again. And as it continues to rotate, you can see we're just going through this cycle of day, changing into night, changing back into day. This 24-hour cycle of day and night based on the rotation of the Earth. So even though this is a very simple demonstration, it's a great way to visualize just what's happening to the Earth as it rotates on its axis, as we experience day and night on Earth.